My name is Akash Tripathi. I am Vice Chair, Kite IEEE SB. So let me take this opportunity to provide you a brief introduction about our speaker for today, Dr. Ajit Kumar. Dr. Ajit Kumar is a gold medalist from Delhi College of Engineering, 1980 electrical batch. He did his PhD in management and MBA in finance from IGNU. Dr. Ajit Kumar joined PTC India Limited as Director, Commercial and Operations on 2nd of April 2015. And has completed his tenure of 6 years in April 2001. He was also managing director of PTC Energy Limited and has commissioned 300 megawatt renewable energy projects in PTC Energy, a 100% subsidiary of PTC. Before joining PTC, he worked in NTPC for 35 years, a very long tenure, I say. During his tenure in NTPC as executive director, commercial, he was responsible for sale and realization of bills of rupees 75,000 crores for 235 BU electricity supplied annually. As a head of business development, he has played a key role in finalizing and signing off various agreements with Bangladesh Power Development Board for establishing a 2,660 megawatt thermal power project in Khulana with Ceylon Electricity Board and for establishing a 250 megawatt thermal power project in Trichinopoly. At different management levels in NTPC, he was also responsible for delivering design and engineering inputs, quality assurance and inspection services, and procurement of site support. He has also traveled to many countries for business development, presenting papers in international seminars, and for type testing of equipment sourced from various countries. Such a vast horizon of a bio, our speaker for today, Dr. Ajit Kumar. So kindly start with your session, sir.
We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, Samarth. Thank you, Akash. Thank you, Dr. Brajesh. And welcome to all my friends and colleagues. I'll call you as my colleagues and friends because when I'm talking to you, I'm getting very nostalgic that after such a long time, long gap, I am back to the engineering students. Of course, I was connected to the academics while doing my MBA and my PhD, as he has mentioned. I have not done my MBA and PhD or engineering together in one go. It was after a gap of 10 years, so that you have a good experience of working in the industry and see what I need to learn more. So I went to MBA Finance. Maybe I will narrate you why I chose the finance. And then after working for another 15 years, I did my PhD. Once again, the subjects were related to the power plant engineering as well as costing and finance. So this is a very golden moment for me and for all of us who are sitting here to share my thoughts with you and to tell you what future lies ahead for you. That is what the basic concern is of the students who are in the third year and fourth year because of the situation, what is prevalent and what is emerging out. How do we plan our studies? How do we plan our job? Because ultimately we got into this engineering field to get and land a beautiful or handsome job. But the situation is quite difficult. Every day we see in the newspapers that so many people are losing jobs, so many recruitments are not happening. But at the same time, Government of India is taking a lot of good initiatives to do the spending through the public sector undertakings. They are giving a lot of boost, a lot of money to the PSUs and fixing a very high target for them to spend money on the capital projects. So they will need a lot of people in almost all the sectors. That is the Atmanirbhar package, what we have been listening here. And parallelly, after some time, once the second phase goes away, the private sector will also come up and will have a good scope for the recruitment. A lot of recruitments are happening now also and will happen in the future also. So let us not worry about that, what will happen to me. The basic thing is that we are in a third year or fourth year. We have to study, we have to learn the basics because these 2 years are very critical as far as building your career is concerned or building your mark sheet is concerned or building your CGPA is concerned. You must do your studies thoroughly, do your projects very diligently. Let's not get carried away ke bhai exam to ho nahi rahe to kya karna hai. So I can break into Hindi English, that will be comfortable, not necessarily that we speak in English. Now the screen is visible, I suppose.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we start from here.
Yes, sir.
So as the topic was discussed, GATE and jobs in the public sector. So this is what I have prepared. And what are we going to discuss? First of all, why this lecture? What is the importance? What are the takeaway we are going to have from this lecture? We will discuss briefly. Then we will discuss what is PSU. Although most of you may be knowing, but it is better I give you a overview of what is PSU. Then we will discuss what are the job opportunities in PSU, how do we get those jobs, what are the methods, how do I prepare for the interviews, what is the GATE relevance, how do I prepare for the GATE, and how do I prepare for the job. So in this lecture, we will basically discuss PSU means public sector undertakings, and what is the GATE. Hello, are you able to listen to me?
Yes, sir.
And the GATE exams, GATE stands for Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. We will discuss that. What are the types of job opportunities available in the various PSUs? What are the requirements for getting those jobs? And what are the expectations of these companies who are recruiting the fresh graduate engineers for their activities? What are the salaries, perks, promotions in PSU? What do we expect? How much they pay, what are the facilities available in various PSUs. We can slightly discuss how does it compare with the public-private sector as well. Tips for GATE exams, what is the GATE exam, what are the contents of the GATE exam, what we need to prepare for the GATE exam. I have also included a brief schedule for the GATE exams of 2022. What are the timelines for this, and how do we prepare for the interview. I have included some tips we can then discuss in detail about. As I told you, PSU stands for Public Sector Undertaking. Then the private sector is PVT, SEC, what we call. There is another model which the government has built is PPP, PPP, Public-Private Partnership. There are many companies which have been formed where the government of India and the private sector joins hands and forms a company where the private people are given a free hand to run those companies. The PTC, NTPC, I was working, NTPC is a pure PSU, whereas a PTC is a PPP model, is a public-private partnership model. The government of India has invested some money through the public sectors. They control certain operations through their board nominee, but the day-to-day operations are private. They don't interfere. How do you work? Why do you work? I'll tell you what are the difference of working in PSU and PPP model. Then the company where the government holds more than 50% shares, these are called private undertakings. What was the need to start these private public sector undertakings? In fact, when the country was gained independence, we had very little manufacturing. It was an agriculture dominated economy. Today also we have agriculture dominated economy, but now the role of industry has increased substantially. The large industries as well as the MSME. MSME is playing a big role. MSME means micro, small and medium enterprises. There is a limit on the overall turnover which has been put on these industries, like micro, wherever you have up to 100 crore turnover, which are called micro, up to 200 is small, up to 500 is medium. That is the annual turnover. Government has identified these MSMEs and has given certain benefits in the form of taxation and incentives for these companies to flourish. And let me tell you, MSME sector is contributing today 40% towards the GDP total. So MSME is playing a big role. And there are many PSUs in MSME sector also, small. So the government of India started building up large companies like the steel companies, power plant companies, like the hydro projects, dams, wherever the technology was required. We had to import the technology. The private sector was not ready to put the money into that heavy technology, whether it will succeed or not. The government of India came forward and imported that technology, proven it, and then implemented this. Then PSUs are of two types, central and state PSU. Central means which is promoted by the government of India, central government. State PSU means these are the promoted by the state sectors, by individual states, which are where they have the controlling factors. This slide just gives you a glimpse of about the CPSUs, because I have not covered much about state PSUs. We should focus on CPSUs where you have a control on that. So In this 348 CPSUs, total 10.3 lakhs people are employed at various levels, right from the technician or the worker level to the topmost CEO and the chair CMD level. Investment in these PSUs, 16.41 lakhs crores, huge investment. 1 lakh crore is 1 trillion rupees, you can say that. And total paid up capital is 2.75. When we say paid up capital and investment, paid up capital means the owner invests this money. The balance different 14 lakh crores is borrowed from the market, from the banks, from the lending institutions, from the World Bank, from IDBI, from ADB, Asian Development Bank. These people give the money to these institutions, backed up by the government of India, at a very relatively low interest rate, so that you can build large projects. Total revenue per year from these companies is 25.43 lakh crores. But out of 348, it is only 178 CPSUs which are giving a profit of 1.75 lakh crores. I'll come to the next slide and tell you on which CPSUs we need to target. Not of these 178, even slightly less number. Overall net profit is 1.42 lakh crores. That means 30 lakh crores is a loss by the other 150 odd CPSUs. These CPSUs have so far contributed 3.68 lakh crores in the form of dividend. When a company makes a profit, they declare a dividend. Profit sharing, what we call. Many of you may be knowing, because when you invest in shares, you get a dividend depending on the profit a company earns. CSR expenditure means corporate social responsibility. That is a law now in the government of India, that whatever you are earning, if you are making a profit, then 2% of that profit has to be spent on CSR activities. The list is identified by the government of India. You have to spend on that money, the money on that. That is paying back to the society, because whatever companies are doing, we are using water, we are using air, we are using the manpower, we are using the nearby infrastructure. So we need to give back to the society. That is why this CSR expenditure. You can note down your questions. We will have the question answer session at the end. Now, the various types of CPSUs are, there are three categories. Now, this is very important. You must listen to this very carefully. The government of India has divided this PSU into three categories. One is Maharatna, another is Navratna, third is Mini Ratna. Maharatna companies are those companies which are making profit of 2,500 crores per year for the last 3 years. These CPSUs are identified as Maharatna companies. Advantage getting qualified or getting categorized into this is that the board has the full freedom to take any investment decision, any welfare decision for the employees. They don't have to the government of India or to the ministry or to the investment board for taking a clearance that we want to build a new project. Can I invest 500 crores? No. So there are around 10 or 11 companies which are categorized into Maharatna companies. So we must aim to get into these Maharatna companies first. Aim should be to get into these Maharatna companies. The list is available on the web. I will just tell you some major Maharatna companies. One is NTPC, BHEL, Power Grid, ONGC, Indian Oil, Oil India, Gas Authority of India Limited, then there's Steel Authority of India Limited. These are the 9, 10, 11 companies which are known as Maharatna companies. And all these Maharatna companies are recruiting their fresh engineers through GATE exams. Mind, please note, all these Maharatna companies are recruiting fresh engineers through GATE exams. Earlier, we were conducting our own exams. I was involved into, because of being good at studies, I was involved into making question papers, evaluating them, sitting in the interviews. But now we have stopped doing the question answer. Reason being that if you have a 1,000 vacancies, you get application from around 1 lakh of engineers. So the ratio becomes 1:100, which is very, very difficult, and becomes very difficult for each company to conduct these exams. So after discussion with the IITs, it was decided that these CPSUs will go for recruitment through Maharatna companies. So we must focus, we must aim. Those of you who want to get into PSUs, should aim to get into Maharatna companies. Then these are Navratna companies. There are around 40 to 45 companies. This Navratna word basically came from the, you know, Akbar Darbar. He has Navratans, courtiers, nine excellent courtiers. So this term came from there. Initially, it was only Navratna. There are 4 or 5 companies who became Navratna. But when their profit increased, many companies were making a profit. So they were finally categorized into 3 categories. So Navratna means these are the companies who are making a profit of at least 1,000 crores. And there is one more terminology, MOU, Memorandum of Understanding. Government of India, through its various ministries, makes a MOU with each company, with each CPSU every year at the beginning of the year, that what are you going to achieve? What are your targets? So it's a target-based MOUs. And in these targets, 50% marks are assigned to the financial parameters. What is your profit now? How much profit you will increase next year? What is your net worth? How your net worth will increase? How you will reduce your cost? What are your going to be borrowings? When are you going to list? What are your market capitalization? These are the parameters which are monitored by the government of India to ensure the health of these Maharatna and Navratna companies. So these MOUs are very important. So Maharatna companies have to score 75% to 80% plus. Navratna companies have to score 60% plus. They must score 60% marks in the MOU which is set in the initial year. What we say is a KRA, key result areas, or what we say is a target that I want to achieve my 8 CGPA in the final year or 8.5 CGPA in the final year. I put a target for myself and see what we achieve. And many Ratna are the companies which are making profit of the order of 50 crore to 100 crore every year and score 50% and above. But these companies, many Ratnas, for any investment have to go to their respective ministries for taking approval for investing in any new project. Like I'll tell you a small company, it's called SJVNL, Satluj Jal Vidyut Nigam Limited. This is a joint venture company between CPSU and Himachal government. They are building a lot of hydro and thermal projects, but they are categorized into mini Ratna company. Now, if they want to put a small 50 megawatt solar or wind projects, they will have to go to Government of India. But if you take a Maharatna company, if NTPC or Power Grid wants to build a project where the investment is going to be of 2,500 crore every year, they don't have to go anywhere. They have to just go to their board. And the ministry representative is there on the board of all these companies. So they go and control. Generally, there are 2 representatives from every ministry. One is the Joint Secretary Finance. Every ministry has a finance member, and one is the Joint Secretary of the corresponding function. So these are the categories of PSUs. So we have to target, if at all we want to go to PSUs, we have to target the Maharatna companies. What are the job opportunities? As I told you, Maharatna and Navratna companies recruit their fresh graduates based on GATE scores of a particular year. It is very important. If I am looking to get into a PSU in 2022, my GATE score of 2022 only will be seen. It is not that I appear in 2022 in GATE and apply for a job in PSU in 2023. Your score will not be considered. Please ensure that if we are planning to get into PSU, we aim for a very good score in GATE. We'll discuss further that how can we get a GATE score and what is the pass percentage of the GATE. It is not an easy test because of certain conditions and because of the certain parameters which are tested over here. So these companies, Maharatna and Navratna, when they want to recruit engineers, let's say now we are in 2021, and they have to recruit their people in 2022. So they will place an advertisement in the newspaper along with the GATE exam notification, which generally comes into July, August. Like in GATE exam of 2022, notification will come maybe July or August 2021. Once this notification comes, these Maharatna companies place an advertisement in the newspaper that we are going to recruit so many engineers in 2022 of different branches. But we will be recruiting through the GATE exam. we will discuss in detail when we come to the GATE exam. And the shortlisting procedure in the PSU is that if there are 1,000 vacancies, let us say NTPC wants to recruit 1,000 engineers of different branches, electrical, mechanical, civil, C&I, computers. So they will be shortlisting 5,000 candidates. That means there will be a ratio of 1:5, almost 1:5. The candidates who will be shortlisted based on their GATE score. It is simple mathematics. Based on your GATE score in the descending order, you are shortlisted and you are called for interview. So if we want to appear in these PSUs, we have to be amongst the better scorer, top scorers. But how do we score better in the GATE? We will discuss in the next few slides. What are the salary and perks in PSUs? How do we compare in private sector? Starting salary in PSU is 5 to 7 lakhs. This is very good as compared to private sector. Like I came from PTC. In PTC or in any private sector, you might have seen the salary ranges from 2.5 to 3.5 lakhs. Even many of you know those who go for TCS or Infosys or Wipro, they also get in the salary of 3 to 3.5 lakhs, not anymore. So initial salary in PSU is high for the first 10 years. But subsequently, the salary structure reverses and the private sector pays more. So you can switch over if you want from the public sector to private sector after working for 8 to 10 years because that becomes your base, that what salary you have got. In this salary, the basic salary structure, when I say the basic salary structure, the salaries band are fixed by the government, by their pay commissions. Like an engineer will get a salary structure of 40,000 basic pay, 3% increment, and top off this will be around, say, maybe 75,000. The increment is also fixed for every employee in the organization is fixed. It is 3% of your basic pay every year. Every employee will get only this much increment on the 1st of April. But there are controls. The performance gets rewarded. The performance gets monitored. If you see the perks and performance and your promotions, these are related to your performance. How do you work? It's not that you have got into PSU, government mein job mil gayi, ab kya kaam karna hai, ab toh jo bhi hai, theek hai. Not that way. You have to perform. Then only you get your performance related pay, which is 40% of your basic at the starting level. And at the top level, it is 100% of the basic. For the CMD, it is 200% of the basic. So everybody, whatever MOU we sign with the Ministry of Power or the Government of India, every company in the Maharatna and Navratna signs MOU, which I was explaining. This PRP is given based on that. If you are scoring 90% and more, then you get the full PRP. That means either 40% or 70% or 100% or 200%, whichever is linked to your grade. But if your score is less, then this PRP goes down. So this PRP has two components. One is the company level performance. One is the individual level performance. You have performed better. Company has not performed. So you will get a mix of the two. So it is a weighted average PRP you get. So everybody's performance is important if the company has to perform better. It cannot be that the individual perform better and the company doesn't perform. It can never happen. So it has to be every department has to perform, every function has to perform, because ultimately everyone is working to increase the top line and bottom line. The perks, when I have written, the basic salary structure the government announces is the basic salary and the DA. DA is the dearness allowance, which is basically dependent on how the inflation is in the market, how the things are becoming costly. There is a formula by the Department of Public Enterprise, and they release the how much DA will increase. Like in, you might have listening, Government of India gives to its own employees 6% DA increment. That means 6% means if you have a 40,000 rupees your basic, so 6% of that 2400 will be the DA that you will get. So that is how the your salary further salary increase or the compensation towards the inflation or the mehngai bhatta, what you call is. You get paid for this. But the PRP is a very, very important component here, that if you perform better, you get more salary. And the other perks, what we call is, this is available only in PSU, not in the central government. In the central government, you get only basic and DA, that's all. While in PSU, you get basic, you get DA, you get perks, you get PRP. In the perks, there is, it is a 50% of basic. That means you have 40,000 rupees basic, or a 1 lakh of basic, you will get 50,000 rupees as an allowance. It is a bouquet of the various perks, and you can choose from that what component you want, you take at 50% of your things, and then you can save on your taxes if you want. Certain parts are taxable, certain is not. I'll just give an example what is covered in this. Like in the perks, it is covered like LTC. It is covered like education allowance for your children, cafeteria allowance, medical allowance, and your uniform allowance. So many allowances are covered in the, there are 10 to 15 heads which are identified, and one is allowed to pick up that which component you want to choose. You are given newspaper allowance, you are given dress allowance, you are given cafeteria allowance. Many, many, many things are there which are there, one can choose from there. And but certain Maharatna companies give over and above their perks, like I told you, medical, NTPC, or the Power Grid, or the BHEL, gives 100% medical reimbursement for the employees, their dependent parents, wife and children. There is no question asked. They want you to be tension free as far as the medical part is concerned. There is a limit fixed based on the AIMS are the main hospitals in the city, which are good private hospital like Gangaram Hospital in Delhi. They fix the payment as per those charges. But certain companies like Navratna and Maharatna, they include the medical as part of your perks. So that is why I was telling you that you should target for Maharatna companies if you want to have more salary, better perks, better facilities. Promotions are time-bound and performance-based. Every employee is asked to fill in the beginning of the year, what are you going to do, what are you going to achieve in the next year, in this current year. So all these Maharatna companies do this process where they are called KRA, key result areas. You have to identify your key result areas in your technology, what are the works you are doing, in your personal improvement, that what are the leadership qualities you have, how you manage your time, how do you work with your team members, how quick you are in resolving the issue, how fast is your response. So all those parameters are judged. And based on that, you are categorized into excellent, very good, good, meets the expectation, not satisfactory. So A, B, C, D, E, these are the five evaluations. And then there is a bell curve which is adopted in all the Maharatna companies, that not more than 20 to 25% people can be a super performer. You cannot, your supervisor cannot categorize 50% people as the top performer. So there's a competition in the Maharatna companies. So PSU doesn't mean that the government company. So if you don't perform well, you may get your salary, you may get your basic increment, that's all. Your perks and PRP, your promotions will be affected. Like in, I tell you about myself, I am a 1980 graduate. I joined NTPC after briefly joining L&T for 4 or 5 months. NTPC, I joined 1980. There were 400 executives who joined with us, and only 2 became directors, and only 10 became executive directors. Many of them retired at GM and DGM level. Why? Because of the performance. So we must be very careful that I am going to PSU doesn't mean that I have got a job and now I have to relax. कोई काम करने की जरूरत नहीं है, अब तो सरकारी कंपनी में आ गए. ऐसा नहीं है. सरकारी कंपनी में आ गए, your job is secured, you will keep on getting the salary, nobody will ask you to leave. But subsequent, now you might have seen that this present government has done the compulsory retirement scheme also. They have retired certain very senior IAS officers because based on their performance. Although it has not come into PSU, but if it goes on, it may come. So the performance is very, very important, and performance matters everywhere, wherever you are. Posting is an all India basis. Most of these Maharatna companies are spread all over India, in rural areas, in cities, in metros, in district towns. So you should be ready to get posted everywhere. But at most of the time, most of the places, you are given a decent accommodation where the company allows you to rent a house, and they give you a leased accommodation where they give you a handsome amount for buying. Suppose I'll tell you an example. Suppose you have a basic pay of 40,000 to 1 lakh. So 40% of top of your salary band is your entitlement for your house rent. So you can buy a house for 40,000 rupees. You can rent a house for 40,000 rupees. That is what the company looks after. Well, they give, if you want to buy a house, they give you a loan for around 25 lakhs at a very concessional rate. They give you a loan for the car, for the vehicle at a very concessional rate. So these are the facilities which the government gives, but they want you to perform. They want you to be ready to get posted anywhere and everywhere. Mind it, I'll get come to the fourth bullet again. Time bound and performance based. One should be very clear. Even if I am in PSU, my growth, my promotions, my PRP will depend on my performance. Performance is key everywhere. Even when you are in a college, it is your performance which is being evaluated by your peers, by your by your professors, by your teachers, based on which you are awarded marks. And these marks take you on to the further steps. Now we come to the GATE exams. As I told you, GATE stands for Graduate Aptitude Test Engineering. I think we're left with 10, 15 minutes. Can we continue after 7, or we have to stop at 7? Hello?
Yes, sir. We can continue.
Okay. I think then I'll give some more time on explaining this thing than on the time. I have kept my 1 hour extra for you people. We can discuss. No issue.
Yes,
so, GATE exams is, if you want to go for a postgraduate education in the country, it is mandatory. If you want to do M.Tech, or if you want to do MS, or if you want to do PhD, this is required. If you pass a GATE test, come to the second bullet, the government of India gives you a scholarship of 12,500 rupees. But if you do the M.Tech from private college, they may give you an admission, but they will not give you this scholarship. If you want to get admission into IITs or NITs or into other government colleges, then this GATE exam is must. This GATE is conducted by either Indian Institute of Sciences Bangalore, IISc is Bangalore, and there are 7 IITs. So all these 8 institutions, one by one by rotation, are given a responsibility to conduct the GATE exam every year. One of the institution becomes responsible for conducting the GATE exam every year, and this is rotated amongst all these 8 institutions. So nothing is fixed. There is a single exam. It is a 3 hours duration. It is a computer based. It is held once every year, generally in the first quarter. When I say first quarter, means January, February, March. Generally it is in February it is conducted, and in 1 month the results comes out. But depending on the situation, depending on the environmental conditions, what is happening nowadays, this may get rescheduled. But most of the times it gets conducted in first quarter. Score is valid for 3 years. When I say score is valid for 3 years, this is for admission to your higher education, postgraduate education and PhDs. But for getting admission, but for getting recruited into PSU, you have to have a score of that particular year. For getting a job in 2022, GATE score of 2022 only, not of 2021. If you want to get a job next year, you want to prepare, then you must appear in GATE 2023. Those who are in third year, those who are in final year. Test is conducted only in English language. It is conducted in 27 disciplines, and candidate can only choose one. When I say 27 disciplines, it has various branches of engineering. Now humanities, mathematics have also been added, because the environmental engineering, there are so many given, and list is available on the web, you can see. But electrical, mechanical, civil, these are the core areas which are already there. I've already explained that if you want to go for postgraduate studies in any of the IITs or the government funded institutions, if you go through GATE, there is no question of if, you have to go through only GATE, you get this 12,500 rupees per month as a stipend. Let me tell you now, this next bullet is maybe a little scary. 8,58,000 students applied in 2020, and only 18.8% qualified. It's not an easy exam. Don't think that you have qualified, you will get the result. Those who qualify only get the result. Those who do not get qualified, they don't get the result. Next slide, I have a benchmark score for you. How much if you score, you there are chances of getting qualified. It's not easy, but it is not tough also. It just needs an application of mind. Eligibility is only final year students and those who have graduated. Third year students cannot apply. Those who are in third year now or will be completing third year in 2022 are not eligible to apply. Those who will be completing final year in 2022 are those who have already completed their graduation in 2021 or 2020 can apply for 2022 gate test. Now, exam pattern is that there are 65 questions for 100 marks and you have 3 hours time. This is MCQ. 4 answers, only 1 is correct. MSQ, sampling questions, where 1 or more could be correct, you have to apply your mind, you might have to do some calculations. And numerical answer type, where you will have to do the calculation and fill your answer. Most of you may be appearing in JEE also, this is the pattern what they follow. The beauty here is, if you had a computerized test is being given, 2 students are sitting nearby or close by, questions, 165 questions will be same, but they will appear random wise. Maybe the question which is there on my side students, my side colleague will be different and my question will be different. So it comes under randomized. So let us be understanding that I have to prepare for myself. I cannot depend on someone else who will help me because time is very less. Everyone has to focus only on his screen, only on his application of mind. And they come in a randomized manner. One should be very clear about this. Out of the 65 questions, 10 questions are of general aptitude, verbal and numerical. Verbal means English, numerical is mathematics. 55 questions are on your technical, on the chosen subject. Chosen subject means electrical engineering, that's all. Not that electrical engineering you choose that I will go for power system, I'll go for motor design, I'll go for measurement, I'll go for switchgear technology, no. There will be questions asked on all the subjects, but they are very, very basic fundamental questions, which we have to be clear. There is a negative marking only for MCQ, MCQ and MSQ, but there is no negative marking for the 55 questions. So we should not be afraid of preparing for this. Syllabus, there's a verbal, grammar, sentence completion, verbal analogies, etc. Like verbal analogies means finding a good leader is like finding a needle in a haystack. These are the verbal analogies what we have to see. The person is boiling like a hot water. These are the verbal analogies. One may say that are 15 number hi to hain, 10 question hi to hain, 15 marks to chhod denge. Nahin. You cannot leave it and expect you to get qualified and get good scores. Numerical is very simple, mathematics, data interpretation, numerical reasoning. This is very simple for all engineering students. But English, one has to prepare. I have just told in the next slide, how do we prepare for this? Technical is technical questions related to the subject chosen, nothing beyond. Scores are issued only to the qualified candidates. Please, everyone will not get the scores. Pass percentage is 18 to 19%, but those who are getting 35 to 50 marks out of 100 are sure to get qualified. So you can understand that the exam is not simple, but the exam is not tough also. What we need to do to get in the qualified list? We have to plan for gate early. If I have to appear for 2022, I am in third year, I must start preparing now. If I am in fourth year, I have to do an intensive preparation. Intensive. In third year, you can do side by side. But in fourth year, you have to do intensive preparation. Because it has a lot of attached lucrations that you are going to get into Maharatna companies, or you're going to get MS into well-known or well-rated institutions. The very, very focus point is that be attentive in your classes for your basics. If you understand what teacher is talking, what professor is explaining, ना भैया नोट्स बना लेना, हम तुम्हारा देख लेंगे, एग्जाम बना के दे देंगे, नहीं चलेगा. असाइनमेंट्स कॉपी करके दे देंगे, उस समय तो हो जाएगा, गेट में नहीं हो पाएगा, वो फिर समझ में नहीं आएगा. लाइक आई टेल यू सिंपल एग्जाम्पल, मैनी ऑफ यू मे बी नोइंग, सम ऑफ यू मे नॉट बी नोइंग इवन, दैट वी से द एनी ट्रांसफार्मर हैज टू टाइप्स ऑफ लॉसेस, वी से आयरन लॉसेज एंड कॉपर लॉसेज. आयरन लॉसेज इज ओनली इन द स्टैम्पिंग्स इन द कोर and is of two types, tray losses and eddy current losses. That is why the cores are laminated. But I don't know, many of you would have noticed that the cable conductors, cable cores are also stranded. What is the need to strand it? It needs efforts, it needs money, it needs time. It is to reduce the losses. Which losses? Eddy current losses. So now we are trying to reduce the eddy current losses, not only from the iron stampings of the motor or the transformer, but from the copper conductor also, which has a copper loss also, which has a eddy current loss also. So why they are stranded? To reduce eddy current losses. Why the eddy current losses? You must study the basics. One should understand what we are talking. Another question can be, which transformer has to have an all day high efficiency? We know transformer is a static machine which has a very high efficiency as compared to the motors. But in that also, we need to know which type of transformer need to have a high all day efficiency. The reason is distribution transformers, which are charged 24 hours a day, but get loaded only during the peak hours. During the off peak hours, when the domestic load is not there, the transformers are lightly loaded. If they are lightly loaded, then the iron losses are more. So we have to know why this particular question and the basics. So we should be very clear when we are reading. We should not only just read a transformer hai, high efficiency, a static machine hai, ho gaya. Nahi chalega. One should be very clear. We know there is a breather provided in a transformer. Why the breather is provided? What is the reason? If I don't provide the breather, what kind of gas I need to put into the transformer so that the oil dielectric value doesn't go down? So we should understand what we are talking about, what we need to learn. The basics, these are the basics questions which are asked. Nobody will ask you to draw the vector diagram of a transformer in this test. Maybe when you go for interview, they will ask you, because when I went for my first interview in a private company, I was asked to draw the vector diagram of a transformer, and I took 15 minutes each and every vector I explained to them, and that was the interview, that's all. And I got selected there. And they gave me a job of 1100 rupees at that time in 1980. Anyhow, I didn't join that. That was something different. But these things are very, very important to know. You have to know why the current lags the vector, voltage vector. For improving your English, you have to read English newspapers and journals. Only listening news will not help. You have to read a good English newspaper which you can understand. That will take you to the top. If you can't read, there is no need to read the entire newspaper. It is not meant for the students. If you are interested in politics, read about that. Otherwise, read about sports. Don't read Delhi Times. That will not help you. There will be no questions asked. Who is blessed with which sun and where which serial they are working? You will not be asked these questions. Or you read the central page, editorials, write-ups, and the business news, the world news. Each newspaper has categorized now. There is a single page for the business news, one page for the international news, one page for the editorial. One should read these three pages. If you don't have time on a particular day, keep the paper with you. Read on Saturday, Sunday, read on the night, but make it a habit of reading newspaper. English newspaper, sunne se kaam nahi chalega. You have to read. Other way of improving your English, I can tell you, which I applied on my side when I was a student like you. Now also that program comes on All India Radio. There is a news time in the night, 8:45 to 9:00 is a Hindi news. And 9:00 to 9:15 is the English news. Same Hindi news is translated into English news. This will help you to improve your English like anything. Please prepare your English. It is very important. It is not only important for your GATE, it will help you to improve your personality. Because when you go for interview, it is very, very important how do you speak. Not necessary that in the interview you have to speak only English. You can speak in Hindi as well. But whatever you speak, you have to speak correct. So if you understand this, it will improve your personality. You will be able to participate in the group discussions. You will be able to participate in discussions with your friends. You will be knowing what is going. I can give you one more tip. How do you conduct yourself? Because this is when you sit with others, how the other, now you're not able to see me, but if you see me, that you can see on the English, on the TV, when there's a discussion, one-to-one discussion, there are certain programs, when there's a question answer sessions on Delhi Doordarshan or on NDTV or on English news channels, then you see if a question is asked, how the other person responds, what is his body language? That is very important. Whether you keep your eyes straight, keep your chin up, or you put your head down, sir, nahi aata hai, kya karein, aise nahi chalega. So you must start focusing on your English. Important is stay focused. I've kept it at the end so that we remain focused. We know I've not kept it at the top intentionally. Stay focused. Even if you don't want to prepare for GATE, even if you don't want to go for PSU, you have to know the basics. You have to know about the English. You have to know what is happening in your environment to perform. Because in the private sector, it is only performance. If you're not performing, you may be awarded even a 0% increment. You may not get increment. And if you get, if you're graded low for two consecutive years, you are asked to go. That is in the private sector, not in the public sector. So these are the important updates for GATE 2022. This time IIT Kharagpur is organizing the exam. Notification will be published in the newspaper in third week of July 2021. Application will be released in second week of September 2021. Last date to fill is first week of November 2021. And exam date will be announced. It will be second week of February 2022. I hope everything will be all right by that time. Everybody will be vaccinated and we will have not much problem in conducting these exams. Those who are planning to appear for 2022, please watch these dates. Keep looking at the newspapers. You will get notification. Of course, many times college placement team also helps for getting these dates notified on the notice boards. So what are the tips for job interview? When you go for job interview, whether it is a public sector or a private sector, so we should be thorough with the sector and company you have chosen. Like sector, I say, like you want to go for NTPC. NTPC is a power sector company. So we should know what is a power sector. Power sector consists of generation, transmission, and distribution. So we should be thorough about all these things. NTPC is a company into generation. So we should know more about generation. NTPC has gone into renewables. So we should know about renewables. If I want to go to ONGC, ONGC is a oil and gas company. So I should know oil and gas, about oil and gas. How the sector, what is the demand, how it is going to improve, what is the role ONGC is playing, what is the role Oil India is playing, how it is going to go up, what are the problems and how, what are the solutions in your mind. This is the study which you need to do. You can choose your one or two sectors, choose one or two companies, because not necessarily that you choose a power sector, you may get qualified into NTPC, because it is relative things, because the scores which are given on the relative marking, 35 to 40 doesn't mean that you will get 35 marks. They are normalized and you may get shortlisted for the interview or you may not, depending how many people are applying over there. So we must choose one or two sectors, two or three companies. It is very important, second bullet, that when you're going for interview, choose one or two subjects. Generally in the interview, I used to ask, which is your favorite subject? We will ask questions on that. Nahi sir, kuch bhi pooch lijiye, then you are doomed. Mere ko to sara kuch aata hai. किसी को कुछ सारा कुछ नहीं आता है. तो वी आर स्टडिंग वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू कॉलेज वॉन्ट्स टू प्रिपेयर यू फॉर बी रेडी फॉर द वर्किंग इन द एनी सेक्टर बट यू मस्ट चूज वन आर टू सब्जेक्ट्स लाइक नाउडेज स्मार्ट मीटर्स आर कमिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लॉसेज आर कमिंग ऑयल एंड गैस इज कमिंग पेट्रोनेट इज कमिंग आर द सिटी गैस इज कमिंग सो वी शुड बी वेरी वेरी क्लियर विच सेक्टर आई वॉन्ट टू वर्क. then which subjects? If someone is good in machines, tell sir anything you can ask in machines, because motor transformers are used in all machines, all factories, all sectors, whichever sector you are. Oil and sector hai, manufacturing hai, switch gears hai. These are used everywhere. But if you choose only the transmission, then you will be only focused only the transmission companies. So choose those subjects which are used all over, like the measurement and instrumentation. This is used in all industries. So you should be, you can ask that I'm thorough with this, you can choose. Like the networks, network theory is used in all the systems. So you must choose one or two subjects, whichever where you have interest, and be clear about each and every line, what the teacher has taught about each and every fundamentals. Brush up your general awareness. We have discussed a lot about this. Face the interviewer, look into the eyes. Not knowing everything is fine. You can say, sir, I don't know. I will have to brush up my knowledge. You might have given a wrong answer. The interviewer may say, no, you are not correct. Sir, I'll be happy to get myself corrected. Please advise me. Don't hesitate. Nahin bataya, nervous, aankhe down, kya hoga, kaan lal, na, nothing to worry about. You will get confident only and only when you are very clear about the fundamentals. In my UPS interview, let me tell you, I was selected for railways also. I was asked only one question, how this tube light works. That was a single question I was asked. Second question was, which type of motor is used in engine in the locomotives and why? So one should be very, very clear about all these things. Why you should explain, not in one line, go into the each and every line. Why we use series motor, what type of series motor, and if I use a diesel engine, whether it is diesel engine or whether it is a motor, it is a motor. Diesel engine generates power through an alternator there. So fine to speak in English in the mix, absolutely no problem, but speak correctly. Don't use wrong sentences. Sentences is very, very important. Don't fumble. And that is possible, which I've told you, listen to English and Hindi newspaper. Listen to the interviews being conducted on TVs one-to-one. Read your newspapers. Conduct mock group discussion amongst yourself. Maybe I am now free. I can help some of you who want to be ready. I'll do that. So one should be very, very clear about what do you want to do, where you want to go. So this is what I have discussed. Now we can have discussions and we can have questions.
Yes, sir. It was a very wonderful session by you, sir. Now I would like from our audience to ask queries and questions if you have regarding your career planning or gate exam. You can also write chat box also. Yeah, Amit Kumar, yes. Please speak
up. हमारा एक सवाल है सर.
हाँ please.
मैं अलीगढ़ यूनिवर्सिटी से भी इवनिंग का स्टूडेंट हूँ, सेकंड ईयर.
अरे हेलो.
हाँ हेलो.
I think it got disconnected.
No sir, your voice is audible sir.
Am I audible?
Yes sir, you are audible.
Please.
हेलो.
Yes.
Yes.
मैं अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी से सर बी सेकंड ईयर का स्टूडेंट हूँ इलेक्ट्रिकल से.
कौन है? He can switch on his video and let me see the face. If someone can is asking. Anyhow, please ask your question. Ask your question. Yes.
मेरा सर ये सवाल है, PSU का फ्यूचर क्या है आने वाले समय में?
देखो आपकी बात बिल्कुल ठीक है.
गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया उसे एक एक करके सेल कर रही है. जैसे अभी आप देख लीजिए, जो सबसे ज्यादा प्रॉफिटेबल कंपनी थी BPCL एक अच्छा खासा डिविडेंड पेइंग थी गवर्नमेंट के लिए. पिछले 5 ईयर्स में 35,000 करोड़ का उसने जो है डिविडेंड दिया है केवल. आज वो गवर्नमेंट उसको बेचने के लिए तैयार है, बैठी हुई है, कोई उसको बायर नहीं मिल रहा जल्दी. इसी तरह आप वन बाई वन देखिए, BHEL कितना बढ़िया एक महारत्ना कंपनी थी. मैं उसका आपको बैलेंस शीट खोल के बताता हूँ सर कि इसने ईयर ऑन ईयर बेसिस अपने इसका सेल्स डाउन होता गया है, मतलब इसका टॉप लाइन घटते गया है, उसी हिसाब से इसका जो बॉटम लाइन है यानी जो प्रॉफिट है वो नेगेटिव में होता जा रहा है. तो ऐसे सेक्टर में हम जब जॉब करने की सोच रहे हैं, या आपने काफी अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन दिया PSUs को लेकर, मैं ये कहूंगा कि सर जब आपने जॉब शुरू किया होगा तो उस समय वो PSUs का एक गोल्डन एरा था, लेकिन आज हम देख रहे हैं कि सारे PSUs एक डूबती हुई नाव है. आप किसी में भी किसी को भी देख लीजिए उसके बैलेंस शीट उठा के, ना तो उनका सेल्स बढ़ रहा है ना टॉप लाइन बढ़ रही है ना ही उनका प्रॉफिट आ रहा है। तो ऐसी स्थिति में हम कहाँ अपने आप को कैसे सिक्योर मान सकते हैं पीयूसीयू में जॉब करके? और आज खुद देख लीजिए कि जो उनकी कंपटीटर कंपनीज है, जो एक तरीके से आप ONGC को एक तरफ रखिए, दूसरी तरफ अडानी गैस को रखिए, इवन रिलायंस को रखिए, उनके प्रॉफिट ग्रोथ और उनके मार्केट कैप को देखिए, और आप सर अपने जो पीएसयू सेक्टर की जो ONGC है उस कंपनी को उठा के देख लीजिए, काफी जमीन आसमान का अंतर है सर। ये जो फासले क्रिएट होते जा रही है, इवन गवर्नमेंट खुद चाह रही है कि हम पीएसयू को बेच दें या उनको हटा दें, तो ऐसे में सर हमारा क्या फ्यूचर है, या पीएसयू का पहले क्या फ्यूचर है फिर हमारा फ्यूचर तो बाद में रहेगा? कंटिन्यू सर।
ठीक है, बिल्कुल बड़ा अच्छा सवाल है, और ये मेरे माइंड में भी था कि जब ये पीएसयू पे लेक्चर रखा गया है तो कुछ सोच समझ के रखा गया होगा कोर सेक्टर्स के लिए, बिकॉज हम लोग सब कोर सेक्टर इलेक्ट्रिकल हैं। देखो पीएसयू का जहाँ तक आपका सवाल है, देयर वाज अ गोल्डन टाइम इन द 60s 80s 90s व्हेन द टेक्नोलॉजी वाज नॉट अवेलेबल, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया वॉन्टेड टू ब्रिंग दैट टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मनी वॉज नॉट अवेलेबल, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ब्रॉट द मनी। आज की डेट में फंड्स बहुत बहुत ईजिली अवेलेबल हैं, और अगर आप देखें जो अच्छे जनरली अच्छे परफॉर्मिंग पीएसयूज हैं उसमें गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया 100% नहीं बेच रही है, अपना स्टेक डाइल्यूट कर रही है। व्हेन आई से एनटीपीसी इज ए पीएसयू, 5 years or 10 years बैक इट वाज 100% पब्लिक लिस्टेड, 100% ओन्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया जान के इनके शेयर मार्केट में ला रही है ताकि इनमें गवर्नेंस बढ़े, इनके जो पैरामीटर्स हैं उनमें ट्रांसपेरेंसी आए, क्योंकि जो बाहर के इन्वेस्टर आते हैं वो गोलमोल बैलेंस शीट नहीं देखते हैं, लीपा पोती जिसको विंडो ड्रेसिंग बोलते हैं उस टाइप की बैलेंस शीट दे डोंट लुक एट इट। गवर्नमेंट इंटेंशनली वांट्स टू ब्रिंग देम टू द स्टॉक मार्केट कि ठीक है जी हम आपके 20% शेयर मार्केट में दे देते हैं, जब आप स्टॉक मार्केट में आओगे तब आपको इन्वेस्टर को फेस करना पड़ेगा। गवर्नमेंट में तो अगर आपकी एक CMD की दोस्ती सेक्रेटरी के साथ मिनिस्टर के साथ खाली दो आदमियों के साथ अच्छी हो गई तो अपने 5 साल आराम से बिता लेता, उसे कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं है, लेकिन अब नहीं है वो। अब तो अगर आप अच्छी कंपनी को गवर्नमेंट ने लिस्ट इसलिए कर दिया है कि आप हर 3 महीने बाद अपनी ऑडिट कराइए, अपने रिजल्ट सामने लाइए, एक स्ट्रेटेजरी ऑडिट बैठता है, उसके बाद CAG बैठता है, फिर आप इन्वेस्टर कॉन्फ्रेंस करते हैं, 4 इन्वेस्टर कॉन्फ्रेंस होती हैं, फिर एनुअल जनरल बॉडी मीटिंग होती है जिसमें इन्वेस्टर आपकी आई यूज अवर धज्जियाँ उड़ा देते हैं, दे वॉक थ्रू योर स्किन कि आपने ये इन्वेस्टमेंट कैसे दिखाई है, आपने एक्सपेंसेस कैसे दिखाए हैं। तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया अपनी अच्छी अच्छी कंपनीज को लीवरेज कर रही है। 2 एडवांटेज हैं गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया को, एक तो जो उन्होंने इतनी ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट की थी उस समय जब कोई नहीं आ रहा था, आज उस सेक्टर को मेच्योर कर दिया है, और फिर अगर आप स्टॉक मार्केट में जाते हैं उसकी वैल्यू बढ़ गई, अगर कंपनी ने परफॉर्म किया तभी उसकी वैल्यू बढ़ी है, नहीं तो उसकी वैल्यू बढ़ती नहीं कभी भी। आज NTPC का शेयर अगर 50 रुपये वाला शेयर 200 रुपये में कोट होता है, वो इसलिए होता है कि NTPC की परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी है और आगे भी अच्छी आने वाली है। एक टाइम था ONGC का जो मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन था सबसे हाई लेवल पे था, ONGC का लेवल अगर आपने ONGC की बात की है उसका लेवल लो इसलिए जा रहा है कि उन्होंने अपने आप को डाइवर्सीफाई नहीं किया। दे नेवर सॉ के ऑयल एंड गैस का फ्यूचर हमेशा 100% रहेगा, ऐसा नहीं है। इफ यू लुक एट NTPC ने अपने आप को फटाफट डाइवर्सिफाई कर लिया, दे था कि कोल अगर आएगा तो एनवायरनमेंट पे इम्पैक्ट होने वाला है, कहीं ना कहीं कोई एनवायरनमेंटल शोर मचाएंगे कि आप कोयला बहुत जलाते हो, धुआं बहुत निकालते हो, लोगों को बड़ी परेशानी होती है, तो NTPC डाइवर्सिफाइड इंटू हाइड्रो, दे डाइवर्सिफाइड इंटू रिन्यूएबल्स, सोलर, विंड, और फिर अभी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन में चले गए, बड़े सारे काम कर रहे हैं। जहाँ तक BPCL का सवाल आपने बताया है, गवर्नमेंट को पेट्रोलियम कंपनी 4-5 रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, उस समय 4-5 कंपनी रखी गई क्योंकि हर एरिया में उनको डाइवर्सिफाई करना था, उस समय हर कंपनी को इतना ज्यादा लोन नहीं मिलता था, क्योंकि आज की डेट में जो मार्केट ईज हो गई है, आज की डेट में फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर बहुत आ गए मार्केट में। इफ यू गो 20 ईयर्स बैक फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर थे ही नहीं, फॉरेन से आप बोरो नहीं कर पाते थे, बोरो होता था वर्ल्ड बैंक से या एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक से, वर्ल्ड बैंक अगर देता था तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया की सोवरेन गारंटी मांगता था। आज की डेट में गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया किसी भी PSU को गारंटी नहीं देता है लोन लेने के लिए कि मार्केट से लोन लीजिए। तो जो PSUs परफॉर्म करेंगे वो सर्वाइव करेंगे, उनका गोल्डन ईरा तब भी था, आज भी है और फ्यूचर में भी रहेगा। हम कहेंगे NTPC या NHPC इनका पावर सेक्टर बंद हो जाएगा, ऐसा नहीं है, पावर सेक्टर कभी बंद नहीं होगा, बट इनको डाइवर्सिफाई करना पड़ेगा अपने आप को सस्टेन करने के लिए। BHEL ने अपने आप को खाली कन्फाइंड रखा थर्मल पावर प्लांट और हाइड्रो पावर प्लांट देने के लिए, बट अब उन्होंने डाइवर्सिफाई करना शुरू कर दिया है. दे आर सप्लाइंग मोटर्स टू द वेरियस इंडस्ट्रीज, दे आर ऑल्सो सप्लाइंग नाउ सोलर प्लांट्स, दे आर गोइंग टू विंड प्लांट्स, दे आर स्टार्टेड मेकिंग द सोलर सेल्स. ये चार पाँच साल का पीछे लल पीरियड इसलिए आ गया कि दे नेवर थॉट कि थर्मल में एकदम से लाइन लग जाएगी, ऊपर फर्दर एक्सपेंशन नहीं आएगा. तो आई डोंट थिंक BHEL की अगर आज वैल्यू लो है, अगले 3-4 साल में BHEL जैसी कंपनी बंद हो जाएगी, कभी नहीं बंद होगी, इट विल गो अप. मैंने इसलिए आपको बोला है कि आप लोगों को अगर PSU में जाना है, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू डिसाइड. मैंने आपको प्राइवेट सेक्टर के और PSU के एडवांटेज डिसएडवांटेज बता दिए हैं कि कहाँ आपकी जॉब सिक्योर्ड है, कहाँ आपको सैलरी अच्छी मिलती है, कहाँ प्राइवेट सेक्टर में आपको जॉब तो मिल जाएगी लेकिन परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी नहीं है तो नमस्ते करने में वो देर नहीं लगाते हैं. दे मे टेल यू कि भैया कल शाम से मत आना. PSUs में ऐसा नहीं होता है. तो यू शुड चूज. वेरी गुड, आई वॉज हैप्पी दैट यू आर रीडिंग द बैलेंस शीट एंड यू आर नोइंग हाउ द कंपनी हैज टू बी वैल्यूएटेड. इट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ द स्टॉक मार्केट. एंड स्टॉक मार्केट लेट मी टेल यू हैज बूम्ड बिकॉज ऑफ द लिस्टिंग ऑफ द PSUs. अगर ये PSUs लिस्ट नहीं होते, इतनी ज्यादा इन्वेस्टमेंट, इतने ज्यादा शेयर्स मार्केट में कभी आते नहीं. प्राइवेट सेक्टर तो छोटी छोटी कंपनी 100 करोड़, 200 करोड़, 500 करोड़ में लग जाती है प्राइवेट. और PSU में एक NTPC का प्लांट कम से कम 5000 करोड़, 1000 मेगावाट का लगाया तो 5000 करोड़ से नीचे का प्लांट ही नहीं आता है. एक प्लांट 5000 करोड़ का, 26 प्लांट है ऐसे NTPC के आज की डेट में. ऐसे BHEL के 12 यूनिट हैं, हर यूनिट में कम से कम उन्होंने 1000 करोड़ की इन्वेस्टमेंट कर रखी है. प्राइवेट सेक्टर कभी इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं करता, बहुत कम लोग हैं. अदानी का आपने अच्छा एग्जाम्पल दिया क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने उनको प्रमोट किया कंपटीशन लाने के लिए. अगर मान लो गवर्नमेंट कंपटीशन नहीं लाती तो आज हम पावर सेक्टर में जो कंफर्टेबल बैठे हैं, क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट को भी तो इतना पैसा नहीं है. गवर्नमेंट को भी तो अगर इन्वेस्टमेंट करनी है तो कहीं ना कहीं से फंड तो लाने पड़ेंगे ना. फंड कहाँ से आएंगे? तो प्राइवेट सेक्टर को लाया गया, ठीक है आप एफिशिएंसी लाइए और वो सब काम करिए. तो वन शुड बी वेरी वेरी क्लियर, प्राइवेट सेक्टर पब्लिक सेक्टर हैव टू वर्क इन टुगेदर. खाली एक से काम नहीं चलेगा. बट येस यू आर राइट, गवर्नमेंट सभी पब्लिक सेक्टर PSUs में नहीं रहेगी. अगर ऑयल सेक्टर में 4 कंपनियां हैं तो वो एक में ही रहेगी या 2 में ही रहेगी, बाकी सबको छोड़ देगी. अभी देखिए हमारे NTPC के साथ, मैं बता देता हूँ, NTPC के साथ नीपको और THDC, ये 2 अलग अलग कंपनियां थी पावर सेक्टर की, CPSU, दोनों को इसमें मर्ज कर दिया गया है. तो एक बड़ी कंपनी बना दी जाएगी ताकि वो अपने आप को सस्टेन कर सकें और अपने आप को परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड कर सकें. तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने अभी, जैसे आपने देखा होगा, PFC और REC, ये दोनों फाइनेंस कंपनी थी, दोनों पावर सेक्टर में फाइनेंस कर रही थी, दोनों अलग अलग लीवरेज कर रहे थे, दोनों को मर्ज कर दिया. इसलिए मर्ज कर दिया कि ये अपने आप को बेटर ऑप्टिमाइज कर सकें, मार्केट में अच्छा पैसा ये ला सकते हैं एट ए चीपर रेट और फिर फंडिंग करके प्रोजेक्ट को ला सकते हैं. तो PSUs में अगर जाना है तो वन शुड ओनली अटेम्प्ट ओनली फॉर महारत्ना PSU. आई विल नॉट टेल यू टू अटेम्प्ट इवन फॉर नवरत्ना. इफ यू आर बेस्ट, इफ यू थिंक दैट यू कैन डिलीवर, इफ यू थिंक दैट यू कैन परफॉर्म. बट अगर आपको लगा यार इंजीनियर तो बन गए, अब आगे क्या करना है, नौकरी करेंगे, मजे करेंगे, तो नवरत्ना में कर लीजिए. मिनी रत्न कब बंद हो जाएंगे कोई पता नहीं है. लेट इट बी वेरी क्लियर.
यस सर, इसी सवाल को मैं कंटिन्यू करूंगा. हाँ, जैसे आपको सर पता होगा एनरॉन की जब एक थीम आई थी अपने इंडिया में सबसे पहले प्राइवेटाइजेशन पावर सेक्टर को लेके, उस दौर में शायद NTPC 2 या 3 रुपए पर यूनिट बिजली डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करती थी स्टेट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बोर्ड को, और ये एनरॉन का बिजली जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन था 8 या 9 रुपए हुआ करता था. तो गवर्नमेंट खुद एक तरीके से अपने जो कंपनीज है उसको खुद ही सफेस करती है, मतलब उसको बढ़ने नहीं देती. गवर्नमेंट जो है प्राइवेट को इतना हावी कर रखी है अपने सिस्टम के ऊपर या कह लें PSUs के ऊपर, कि वो सारे जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है वो सबसे पहले प्राइवेट को मिलते हैं. जैसे सर BHEL का देख लीजिए अभी क्या हालत हुआ. अरे सॉरी, BHEL में कह रहा हूँ, BSNL का क्या हालत हुआ. मतलब जो सिस्टम पहले हमें किसको देना चाहिए, मतलब किस अपने अगर PSUs को बढ़ाना था तो पहले BHEL को हमें क्या नाम है BSNL को आगे करना चाहिए था, लेकिन हमने देखिए प्राइवेट प्लेयर्स जियो को, मतलब रिलायंस को दिया उसके हाथों में सारा कंट्रोल. तो इस तरीके से सारे कंट्रोल गवर्नमेंट अपना. मेरा जो सवाल है, जब गवर्नमेंट खुद नहीं चाह रही कि हम PSUs को रखें, आप बिल्कुल बेशक कह रहे हैं कि शेयर डायल्यूट कर रही है. तो सन 2009 से मैं देख रहा हूँ इसका चार्ट पैटर्न देख रहा हूँ इसका NTPC का. ये 2000 मैं सर एक बार टाइम लूंगा थोड़ा सा. ये 2004 से लिस्टेड कंपनी है स्टॉक मार्केट में इंडिया के, और ये आप जो कह रहे हैं सर अभी गवर्नमेंट डाइल्यूट कर रही है, ऑलरेडी लिस्टेड कंपनीज हैं, चाहे BPCL हो या अपनी NTPC हो या फिर NTPC हो, ये ऑलरेडी लिस्टेड कंपनीज हैं, इनके शेयर अच्छे खासे मार्केट में. अभी तक इनके पास क्या था, गवर्नमेंट की 51% से ऊपर होल्डिंग थी तो सारा कंट्रोल इनके पास था, लेकिन अभी पूरा जो प्राइवेट प्लेयर को दे रहे हैं तो एक तरीके से जो अपना कंट्रोलिंग होगी, एक तरीके से पीएसयू फिर रहा नहीं गया ना वो तो।
नहीं नहीं आपके पास बिल्कुल ठीक है। एनटीपीसी को जो एनटीपीसी और बीएसएनएल का मैं आपको रीजन बताता हूँ। एनटीपीसी को जब लिस्ट किया गया 2004 में, उस समय खाली 5% शेयर मार्केट में डाले गए थे। आज की डेट में एनटीपीसी के खाली 15% शेयर ही मार्केट में है, 85% अभी भी गवर्नमेंट के पास हैं। आप बिल्कुल सही एग्जांपल दिया कि एनरॉन आया। एनरॉन एक ऐसी टेक्नोलॉजी लाया अपने साथ जो इंडिया में नहीं थी, गैस प्रोजेक्ट की जो ड्यूअल टेक्नोलॉजी जी की मशीन को लेके आया वो। ये ठीक है, वी आर ए डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री, यहाँ पॉलिटिक्स भी चलती है, पॉलिटिशियन भी हैं, दे हैव ए डिफरेंट इंटरेस्ट। वो जो एनरॉन ने कंपनियाँ चलाईं और हाई प्राइस पे वो पावर बेची उसने, लेकिन एनरॉन का हुआ क्या अल्टीमेटली? अगर कोई कंपनी बिजनेस एथिक्स के साथ नहीं करेगी तो वो सर्वाइव नहीं करेगी। एनरॉन तो डूब गई, एनटीपीसी तो नहीं डूबी। एनरॉन का प्रोजेक्ट आज एनटीपीसी और गेल मिलके चला रहे हैं, एक जेवी कंपनी बना दी गई है, वो दोनों वो गैस लाते हैं, हम पावर प्लांट चलाते हैं, मिलके चलाते हैं। आज भी वो चल रहा है और उसकी पावर रेलवे को दी जा रही है क्योंकि महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट ने लेने से मना कर दिया। तो इट इज बीइंग गिवन टू रेलवेज। और जहां तक आपने बीएसएनएल और एमटीएनएल का सवाल लिया है, वंस अगेन आई विल टेल यू, अगर आप परफॉर्म करते हैं, आप, मैं एनटीपीसी का एग्जांपल इसलिए दे रहा हूं क्योंकि मैं एनटीपीसी में काम किया है या बीएचएल के साथ मेरा क्लोज कोऑर्डिनेशन रहा है। एनटीपीसी के साथ कंपटीशन में रिलायंस भी आया, अदानी भी आया, लेंको भी आया, जेपी भी आया, हर टाइप के प्राइवेट कंपनी आए। एक टाइम ऐसा था कि गवर्नमेंट ने कहा कि हम एनटीपीसी को प्लांट लगाने ही नहीं देंगे, खाली गवर्नमेंट वाले लगाएंगे, खाली प्राइवेट वाले लगाएंगे। एनटीपीसी की टीम चुप नहीं बैठी, एनटीपीसी के मैनेजमेंट ने कहा नहीं, अगर आप हमें थर्मल प्लांट नहीं लगाने देंगे तो हमारे पास फंड है, हम आपको नहीं देंगे, हम हाइड्रो प्लांट लगाएंगे, हम गैस प्लांट लगाएंगे। हमने एक कोल डैम का 800 मेगावाट का हाइड्रो प्लांट खड़ा कर दिया। ये अनफॉर्चुनेट है कि एक प्लांट बह गया अभी जोशीमठ में, आपने पढ़ा होगा। बट 800 मेगावाट का प्लांट खड़ा कर दिया, आज उसकी वजह से ये नीपको और टिपको हमारे अंदर मर्ज हो गए, टीएचडीसी। आज 2000 मेगावाट के हाइड्रो प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑपरेटिंग हैं। उस समय जब कुछ नहीं कर रहे थे तो हमने कोल माइनिंग ले ली सरकार से, भैया ठीक है आप हमें कोल माइन दो। आज एनटीपीसी के पास 10 कोल माइन है और 2 कोल माइन ऑपरेशनल हैं। पूरा कोयला हम बाजार से नहीं लेते, खुद चलाते। तो मैनेजमेंट की, एम्प्लॉयज की विलिंगनेस बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होती है। अगर मैनेजमेंट सोचती कि यार ये तो अब क्या करें, अब तो प्रोजेक्ट तो दिए नहीं, तो अदानी को और रिलायंस को दे दी, हमारा तो कुछ होगा नहीं, नो नहीं होगा, तो फिर आप एमटीएनएल बनोगे या बीएसएनएल बनोगे।
So for survival diversity is required. So diversity PS, जो भी PSU diversity है, diversify करेंगे अपने वर्क को, वो sustain करेंगे, वो survive करेंगे। और ऐसा नहीं है, I think अमित जी ने काफी अच्छा homework कर रखा है business and economics related to power sector, and I really appreciate कि BTech student अगर इस तरह के queries करते हैं तो definitely it's a means good thing means the students are thinking towards this direction. Yes. I think we can go for the next question.
Yes, sir. We have a next question from Shivam Kumar. If my BTech project is not related to power system, is not that a big scale up to mark of PSU that is going to affect during our interview? Basically, he's asking that my project is not that much big as much expectation of getting interview level of PSU. So will this degrade my chances or not?
Nothing. No, absolutely not. They are not looking at that your project is related to power sector or not. During the interview, they will ask you what have you done in your project and how much you are clear about that. Yes. I'll give an example here. In the interview, my final year project was related to operation of 3-phase induction motor on unbalanced voltage supply. I still remember. That was my project which I did in the final year, operation of induction motor on 3-phase unbalanced voltage supply where you get the negative sequence current and the rotor gets heated and all that. In the final interview with NTPC, I was asked by the professor, अरे भाई तुमने ये सब इतना सारा theory निकाल दिया, heat up हो जाएगा, एक किसान जो, this is the way he was speaking interview में. I'm speaking like this to make you comfortable that interviewer are also like human being like us. अगर एक किसान खड़ा हुआ है उसमें अनबैलेंस वोल्टेज सप्लाई आएगी, उसको कैसे पता चलेगा कि मोटर गर्म हो रही है, बंद करना है, क्या करना है? अब मैंने कुछ नहीं किया, मैंने एकदम से सर उसको हाथ रखना है मोटर पे एंड ही हैज टू काउंट अप टू 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. इफ यू कैन काउंट, कीप हिज हैंड ऑन द मोटर इज सेफ, इट विल नॉट बर्न आउट. इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद पावर सेक्टर.
So one yes, should sir. Be very prompt. In I didn't do this in the project, but you should be ready. You should be thorough about the project. That's all. That's what I will say.
Yes, sir. We have a next question from our member Prachi Jaiswal. Tell us about the most challenging engineering project that you have been involved with during this past year, or the most challenging any projects you have been involved with.
See, and NTPC, when I joined, the NTPC was coming up and we were given a lot of freedom to implement new technologies. I'll give you one example which you will be able to relate what you're studying now also. That was during my initial phase when I was doing a switchgear design engineering part, LT, HT, high voltage and that sort. So there was the one component, a medium voltage switchgear, where 6.6 kV, 11 kV and 33 kV is part. The parties wanted to introduce a vacuum circuit breaker at 6.6 kV level also. Whereas we were using at that time MOCB, minimum oil circuit breaker, and we were graduating up to SF6 circuit breaker. See, you might have read in these books, but I'll not go into that, what is the difference. But when you go to VCB, when we're doing the VCB, we ask them to put on two panels and we will test them at the actual site. We found that our motors are burning. Whenever there is a fault or whenever there is a trip command to this breaker, the motor burns. Whereas in SF6, this motor was not burning. So we took this VCB to the lab, to the CPRI lab in Bhopal and Bangalore, and we tested. We gave a breaking command at each point in the wave, in the cycle, which point, where we give a command. Generally, these breakers are supposed to quench the arc at current zero. Even if wherever you give a tripping command on a point of a cycle, the arc should be lengthened. The contacts are designed in a such way that there are arcing contacts, these are main contacts. The arcing contacts are given a horse shape and horse ear shape, so that the arcing gets lengthened and it quenches only at current zero. But in VCB, there was a phenomena of virtual current chopping, where the arc was getting quenched even before the current zero was being achieved. Now I'm going to deep technical, many of you may not understand, but this is the most challenging what we had. So we tested this, that when I was giving a trip command at a different point than the current zero and it was quenching, we measured that the voltage which was coming at the cable was around 20 kV. Whereas the motor's insulation is designed generally for two times of the insulation. Generally two point one times of insulations. So, and we came up with a solution. We put a surge arrestor in the switch gear in the cable side. On the cable point, we put a surge arrestor of the value of around 12 kV for 6.6 kV motor, and then VCB started functioning properly. So this was a very, very challenging things what we had. When we go to engineering things. But then the introduction of the numerical relays. I don't know whether you have read whether the books now contain electromechanical relays or not. Yep. We shifted from.
It is with us in the books, but not in detail. Just a basic introduction about.
Now, from electromechanical relays, we switched to numerical relays. Mm-hmm. But what happened when the numerical relays? Because the components are supplied by different people. One panel is supplied by ABB, other is supplied by GE, other is supplied by Alstom, because it's a bidding system in Government of India. The numerical relays were of different make, and they were not able to communicate with each other. So, I don't know, many of you may be knowing, there is a conference held for electrical engineers every 2 years in France, which is called SIGRE conference.
Yes, sir.
It is a Mahakumbh of electrical engineers,
yes, sir,
where all electrical engineers assemble. So, we discussed this question over there in the SIGRE committees.
Sir, I just want to just share one information here in all the audience. Sir, one of my friend is working with the MP Electricity Board, and he is in the SCADA system. And previously, that initial relays and all the technologies are given by GE. And now the ABB is taken over all that technology, and they have introduced some new things in that SCADA system. And actually now, at present, what happened, the previous team that was is from GE, and now it is ABB. So sometimes they are facing the technical issues in the communication in between the relays or relay coordination. So this is the major disadvantage of a relay system.
I'm telling you, in SIGRE study chapters, we came out with the protocol, IEC 61850 protocol.
Yes, sir.
All the relays have to be compliant with that protocol. so that they are able to talk to each other. So now, when this protocol was adopted, the problem was solved. But we faced many challenges.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay, so Samarth, you take some other question because it's already 7:30.
Yeah, so a lot of students are asking about what are the opportunities related industrial training, like every fourth year student had to appear in industrial training amid COVID situation. Seeing this COVID situation, industrial training is not possible. So how can we overcome this gap, what we are not able to experience industry physically?
Although I agree with you, you cannot do that, but get involved with the industry and do some projects with them, which you can do sitting at home, because you cannot visit the factories, but you should do some projects which can help them, and you can connect with them through this Google or MS team and work with that. Because I will not advise you to visit, but take up projects from those industries which can help them.
One question from Aditi Dubey: will the PSU keep up with digitalization era, or will they stick to traditional method?
If they do with traditional, they have to close.
Yeah,
they have to move on. NTPC was the first company where every time we change from the new technologies.
And sir, one more question from Yash Bharadwaj. Sir, from engineering, why you have changed path and go for MBA? He has asked.
Yeah, very nice question. When I was doing engineering, while interacting with the team, finance, you are asked what is your budget. Every time you have to give a budget. Because in NTPC, I was in a project group. I was not in the operation group. So every time we were planning new projects, we were supposed to give a budget. Budget means they were used to tell, Arey bhai, you are asking 1,000 crore, from where the money will come. Then I used to sit with them, what is the money business? So I can give you, the company can give me only 20% or 25%. 75% we have to borrow. I cannot borrow so much money because I don't have assets which I can leverage. So it became quite interesting. So I thought, let us learn finance. But I continued my work in engineering when I was doing finance. Up to GM level, I worked in engineering department. I was head of NTPC engineering department up to GM. After that, I switched over to commercial business development and all that.
Yes, sir. And two more questions we have. Like, the fourth year non-CSIT student have so much confusion about their preparation, about private sector or government sector, both. How to select between these two sectors? Because in fourth year of a college, if a student prepares for GATE or any other government company, he is not able to get a good score, or for end year, they have no jobs in any of them or both sectors.
No, I don't think I explained very clearly that you have to be focused on the basic principles. Any company recruiting wants engineers who are clear about the fundamentals. We are not going to manufacture relays, or we are not going to manufacture motors, or we are not going to manufacture switch gears. If I know the basics, I can prepare for GATE, I can go to private sector as well. This is a myth that if I am preparing for GATE, I will lose out on this thing. Private sector, yes, they look for smart people, so you should be ready to speak in good English. They will not accept mixing Hindi English, they may not. PSU will accept that. And the English mixing. So you must prepare on the English part very clearly. You should be thorough, because they will do a lot of screening. They will do a lot of group discussions. They will have multiple interviews. They will see whether you can switch your mind very fast from one subject to other subject or not. So these are the basic things. One should be ready about the basics, I will say, that's all.
Sir, what should be the strategies regarding to the subjects which we are studying for GATE preparation? Sir, in which groups or which format we should study for better understanding and for more greater outcomes?
See, I will just tell you, I will not be able to give you pinpointed answer, but I can tell you, you pick up last 7-8 years GATE exams, question papers. You will be able to see the pattern, how it is coming. Only preparing for those 700 questions will not get you a good score, because they will be keep on changing. So you will know how they ask the questions. So you will know the pattern and prepare accordingly. That is how the preparation has to be done. But preparation has to be from your books only, not from those GATE questions.
And sir, one question.
Dr. Bajesh, that's all, nothing else.
Okay. And sir, one question related to our mental situation. Sir, right now this COVID situation is going on. So, sir, how one should motivate himself or herself to keep on trying better and better day by day in this field to achieve a good GATE score? And sir, how to challenge our comfort zone exactly? That how to challenge our comfort zone in this during time? Because most of the time we while away in rather chatting in groups or seeing web series and other non-profitable activities. So, sir, how can we do that?
I will take you to the film Three Idiots. All is well. You say all will be well. That's all. That is the answer. Nothing else. And you must keep focus on your studies. Keep reading your books. Read books from different authors. Stay motivated. You must, if you're sitting at home, do exercises. Generally, I have my son who is also graduated last year from MIT. They will get up at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, no exercise, eat and sleep, keep on watching. Two things go on simultaneously. You are eating also, you're watching, doing games also. Anyhow, children nowadays are capable of doing multitasking, but you have to focus on your studies. Not necessary that you study 10 hours or 12 hours a day. No, not necessary. Study for 2 hours, be kind with yourself, take a gap, move around, eat, watch web series also, and get into the study also. Not that 10 hours for web series and 2 hours for study, that will not help. Time should be equally divided. Be honest to yourself. If I am watching TV for 4 hours, I must study for 4 hours also. That's all, that will take you through. But study daily. Don't say, yaar, 4 ghante daily karne, aaj 8 ghante TV dekhte hain, kal 8 ghante padhenge, wo nahi hoga. Daily that will take you through. Don't worry about that.
Thank you, sir. So thank you, sir, for your valuable time and such a motivation and full of speech, not speech, but rather presentation. And and also thank you for joining us. So now I would like to call Samarth Shukla, IEEE Student Branch KITE Chairperson, for providing you a vote of thanks. Samarth, please.
Yeah. Thank you, Shashwat, for providing me this opportunity. So, good evening once again, everyone. As all good things comes to an end in life, so is this expert lecture. On behalf of IEEE Student Branch KITE, I, Samarth Shukla, Chairperson, take this opportunity to propose vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this wonderful and learning webinar in job opportunities in power engineering and GATE preparation, organized by our branch. As the outset, let me call this it a fraternity of learners here together, and on my own behalf extend a very heartfelt vote of thanks to speaker and resourceful person Dr. Ajit Kumar sir for gracing your important work and sharing with us your findings and opinion today with us. We are really enlightened with your knowledge and presence. We are thankful to our Honorable Branch Counselor, Dr. Brijesh Singh, for their motivational and enthusiastic support. A special thanks to our organizing committee for their unflinching support and coordination. Our heartfelt thanks to all our participants for their active participation. With these warm words and a kind message, we move to end of this today's webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. After this vote of thanks, once again, thank you for joining us and motivating our students towards the all GATE examination, PSUs. And you have contributed a lot of informative things related to public sector. And one interesting thing, most of the students are thinking that what will be the future in the public sector. So definitely you have given an idea, it means how they will choose or select a public sector. So, sir, I hope in future we will connect to each other, and whenever our branch is required your support, we definitely look towards you, means sir, and definitely. Second thing, sir, after this 3-day event, we will circulate all the certificate to the participant as well as the certificate for the expertise also. So once again, sir, thank you.
Thank you. Participants are requested to fill the feedback form present in the chat box and then only leave, because this will be counted as your attendance. And sir, thank you for more than an hour of yours contributing to our branch.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Brijesh, and thank you to all the team members who have joined here and have participated. I am really happy to be amongst you. I am feeling that as if I am a part of you again after 40 years of engineering. I passed in 1980, 75 to 80. That was 5 years course at that time. So I'll be too happy to join with you, and I can interact with any of you if you want. You can reach me at my email ID, which I shared with you. I am reading it again, ajitchhabra@gmail.com.
Yes,
anyone, you are welcome to reach me, and I'll be happy to help you.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks
again.
Stay happy, stay motivated, and stay healthy.